It had to do with the physical size of the parachute. You notice those old parachutes are in a bag that you can't even get in a garbage can. You know, they're great big things. In fact, we used to tease his wife Elaine that she was the only person alive that still knew how to pack a 12-strand chute.
Now, I'm thinking that,
are you ready? Now, anybody that has kids, cover their ears. This is a brand new nitro,
yep.
Clean solvent powered. Notice the difference in the noise?
Yeah.
Now, wait till he backs up onto the fuel system and really laces it to it.
Now, I understand I was talking to Bill in the midst this morning. That's Tony Bartone.
Oh, that is very hard to run the march beat.
Yeah.
And got Roger Union last year. Now, the other part of that equation, one of the most serious drag racers on the West Coast, just stepped up, bought his thing. Put his bullet in it, and he is not going to make him. I hate to do this, but every time I do it, I step on my lip. But I'm pretty sure he told me he was only going to make just a wee bit of a hit, so they can get an idea of what it's going to do.
It is a brand new car, and like you say, they bought the chassis, they bought the bodywork and everything else, but it's Phil's motor that's in there.
And Phil has never driven a car with canards on it.
And that is totally different.
When you start stuffing the rear end down that hard, here we go. Now look at that. On and off the throttle.
Wow. 798, 124 miles an hour. Added to drift over to the center of the tower side. Chris Lund in the dark on the spectator side.
Some of that smoke out of there so Scott can see through the windshield. And then over on the far side, double out of Gearhart, Oregon. And I'm going to say, after the event's over here today, get over and say howdy to these guys. They appreciate it. And they've all
on the ferry.
How much cubic feet you take up on the deck.
Yeah.
Yep.